backstage here at the Georgia Auditorium for the biggest record star show for 1957, talking to Buddy Holly.
Hello, Red.
How are you?
It's fine, man.
Yeah, I missed that phone call we had from Toronto that time.
Yeah, we couldn't get together on that somewhere or another.
I don't know, but I'd just like to tell you right now that your song, Peggy Sue, that you do on a solo there on Coral Records, is the Coral in the States, team?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it's doing real well. It's number 7 song here, and that's lucky number 7, as we say it.
Well, that's fine.
Well, how long have you had the Crickets together, buddy?
Since January.
Since January?
Uh-huh.
When did you decide to form a group up? Was it at that time?
Well, the drummer and myself have been playing together about 4 years, and we got the other two boys and asked them if they'd like to join us and form a group.
You write your own material, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Who helps you with That'll Be the Day?
Jerry Allison, the drummer.
He's the fellow plays drums.
Uh-huh.
Where are you all from? Where's your hometown?
Lubbock, Texas.
Would you like to go back there?
Sure would.
What's the weather like this time of year down there?
Oh, it's not quite this cool.
It's not.
And it's a little bit drier.
Well, right now I'm going to put you on the spot, and I asked you before, and I didn't have a microphone with me, but I'm going to put you on the spot again. What do you think about rock and roll music? Do you think it is on the wane or what?
I think it's going out quite a bit in the States.
Down south?
Uh-huh.
How far down?
Deep.
It is, but I mean, how long do you think it will last? Another 6 months, 7 months?
Oh, possibly, yeah.
I think after Christmas things may change a bit.
It might pick back up, but I rather doubt it.
Well, we'd like to congratulate you here, because in a special way, because the West Coast are sort of responsible for that'll be the day to get it started. It started out here.
That's what I heard.
And we're all real happy about it. Here, Phil Rose of Coppo, of Coral Records and Apex in Brunswick in Eastern Canada, was trying to get through to us with you on the phone back there. How was your engagement in Toronto?
It was real fine. They received us real well.
What you got coming up in the future for records?
Well, we've got one that was just released the other day by the Crickets called Oh Boy.
Oh Boy.
You should be getting that to see any day now.
Well, that's terrific. We'll be playing it just like the other one. That'll mean that you've got 3 songs in our chart that comes up. That'll be Peggy Sue, That'll Be the Day, and Oh Boy.
Yeah.
How do you think it compares with the others?
Well, I like Oh Boy better than That'll Be the Day, really.
You think it's better?
Of course, I'm no judge.
It's always the listeners that decide the fate of a record in the end. We'd like to congratulate you, and I think you've got a good future in the business. One other question, buddy. If trends change, would you hop on the trend and go into the other, or would you just give up?
I'd hop on the trend. because I'd prefer singing a little bit, something a little more quieter in here.
What do you like down in Texas, where you come from? How far is that from a place like Dallas or Crystal City? I mean, Texas is big, man.
Well, our hometown, Lubbock, is 280 miles straight west of Dallas.
It is.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to hit Dallas right off. Wow. Well, it's a real wonderful talking to you backstage here, buddy, and I guess your act goes on pretty soon, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. We're going right after Fat.
How many numbers?
We do 3.
You do 3 numbers. What are you going to do up there?
We'll do Ready Teddy and A New and Oh Boy, and That'll Be the Day.
Well, it's been a real pleasure talking to you backstage. Buddy Holly of the fabulous Crickets.